Like, come on, man. Come on. All right, guys. We have a new poll up that I haven't put in chat yet. I've put it everywhere else, but I haven't put it in for you guys. There is a new Skyrim total conversion mod. Now, when I say total conversion mod, I mean it's not Skyrim. I mean, it is Skyrim, but it's not Skyrim anymore. It runs in the Skyrim game. It doesn't even run in the Skyrim game. It just uses some of the files. So it's probably the engine and the framework, but everything else, like even the start, is completely different. So I believe the map is completely different, et cetera, et cetera. So I am considering playing it. So if you got, gee, Scott, I finished pretty much every Skyrim series we ever did, for the most part. The last one bugged out. It was not against it. That was not something that I dropped. It just wasn't functional. So I can't be held accountable for that. If the damn game breaks, it's not my fault. And that's exactly what happened there. The game just fucking broke. So
all the dragons.
Yeah, that mod pack bundle was so broken from the get-go. It was just ridiculous. So yeah, no, I will finish it if I can, but if I can't, then that's up to them, not to me. You don't think I finished the Dawnguard Archer one? I did all of the Dawnguard. I didn't want to do the the final DLC. What was that?
Dragonborn?
The Dragonborn DLC is a fucking waste of space. I hate that DLC. That DLC was awful.
No, it wasn't, but...
It was terrible. It was like something out of a hentai horror film. It was horrible.
I was just terrified by any form of tentacle.
I just don't like it. I just didn't like it. We'll leave it at that. It was poopy. What about the unarmed one? The unarmed one was broke. It just didn't work. That was another one of those mods that just did not function right. I don't get blamed for that either. So we did, I think it was 6 or 8 playthroughs. We did a full assassin playthrough. We did a full normal playthrough. We did 2 full normal playthroughs. We did an archer playthrough where I did most everything. We did Scottish Jesus where we did more than we should ever have done. What else? I bought Dragonborn literally just for the skill point refunding. Yeah, Ogroach. I mean, that part was nice, but like the dragon riding was stupid and like just...
Yeah, the dragon riding was awful.
Just, it was like the same fucking game over and over, or same map. Like it was all just like these books that were full of tentacles and like the same graphics, the same layout. It was just like, why am I playing this? I don't know. I really didn't like it, but your mileage will vary. I finished the Vamp Lord. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I'm pretty sure we finished her. Alright, I don't want to go there. Let's just do a quick scan. Let's go over here. I'm trying to find some kind of interesting object to land on. What do we got here? I can't even see down to see what it is. Pretty sure it's nothing good. All right, let's kick it back up. Go. Do another scan. There we go. Make Scotty G in the new mod. No, what I'll probably do is an assassin. Either an assassin or an archer assassin. That'll be most likely what I'll do. Okay, nothing big there. I really hate that you can't, like, free look in this. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What is this? Does this have a landing pad? Close enough. We'll land here. Is that a new ship, Pyro? I don't think so. It depends on how far into my No Man's Sky series you are. If you're a sub and you've watched all of the stuff, then this is exactly where the last video left off. Now, granted, a lot of you aren't subs, so you may not have seen the, what do you call it? The new stuff. So, your favorite playthrough was the Assassin one? Yeah, the Assassin one was probably my most viewed series of all time for Skyrim. So, but yes, I agree, Swan. But then, in all fairness, Swan, all Bethesda games are like that. Not just not just stealth, but once you get past a certain point in any of the Bethesda games, you break it. I mean, look at my Melee Survival series. Like, that one was so hard for, like, the first, what, 10 episodes or so? And then it just got to the point where you were just ripping ass everywhere. Like, just tearing buttholes off. God's a troubled one. Yeah, we have, I think it's either two or three other episodes in the pipe for subscribers. So, whoa. Oh, shit, we have the Atlas Pass now. So I can check out some of these, like, little secret doorways and shit. New technology discovered. Okay, it's a bolt caster. I don't like bolt caster. I don't like it. What do we got here? Restore shield. We don't need shield restoration. Is that it? It feels like there should be doors right here, but I guess not. Okay, well, let's bail. Any stealth-type games you're looking for? I love stealth games. Love them, but there hasn't been a good one in a while. Deus Ex. I mean, that has a stealth mode, usually.
Yes.
So, I don't know when... I will call it what I want to call it, bitch. I don't know when that game comes out, though. So, I think I have a contact now at Square, so I may be able to get a copy, maybe. We'll see. Pyro, do you pre-record videos and save them before uploading? Dark Lord Frost, basically what I do is I usually spend the first half of my week recording. So like Monday through Wednesday, I try to get like, you know, a decent amount of episodes out because I stream Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. So like with you guys, I'll be spending pretty much all day with you today. And then after that, I'm pretty much going to eat and just chill for the rest of the night. So yeah, I do pre-record a lot. And the reason I don't just release all that stuff right off the bat is most of my audience doesn't want to watch, you know, six videos in a day. Now, there's some of you who do. But the last time I published, like, eight videos in a day, I lost 200 subscribers. So, Pyro, have you ever played Hitman Blood Money? That's the one of the original ones, right? Echo, I think four or five. I forget which. Poopsicle... My understanding of that game is it's going to be like a zombie survival thing or something. I don't even understand. Troubled One, it's in the series. You just follow the Atlas. Basically, you find the anomaly. You go to the anomaly. You talk to them. They give you the Atlas Pass. And then from there, you get to make a choice of some stuff. And I won't ruin that for you if you haven't seen the episode yet. So, but at that point, you have to kind of make a decision on some things. Does anyone remember off the top of their... It's transmission to find crashed ships, right? I think so. Need a little bit more iron. Are you iron? You are. That'll work. JJ does Minecraft. Or JJ does MC style. People do crazy shit for crazy reasons. So I have no idea, dude. I don't know. I stopped trying to figure it out. Jeez, that's a lot of rain. I think transmissions are ships. So I want to find some ships. So we're gonna look around. Is it a YouTube one? Is what a YouTube one, Troubled? All of my stuff is YouTube. I'll even throw this up later today, so people can see it. Yeah, I want to find a new ship. Because I haven't upgraded my ship in a while. Okay, there's another transmission tower. You got to get ready for soul selling? What? I'm so confused. Thanks, man. I hope it goes well, too. Appreciate you coming and hanging out. All right, so we got a shelter. We're starting to get out like 10 minutes out now. I think I'm going to do a couple. I always found crash ships are garbage. Better off buying them. Eh. I've heard a mix, Poop. I've heard a mix. All right, let's do some shelter ones. I want to get a couple upgrades for my ship as well. Or not my ship, but my suit. Shelter detected. Doesn't look like a drop pod. You're looking to see. I'm looking forward to seeing you fail in From the Depths. What? I'm confused. There's a drop pod. About 5 minutes out. Okay, cool. And we'll do, what, is it two more that I've got? Poop, I think I've got a 22 slot ship. I'm looking to upgrade. There's a drop pod. Okay, so that's two drop pods, and then everything else that we got more is going to be transmissions then. Anything that bumps you up, in my opinion, is on inventory is good. JJ does MC style. Isn't that the, like, ship-building game?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Voxel ship.
I'm not really all that big on building, bro. So, you know, I don't want to say I'll never play it, but building games really aren't my cup of tea. Is there nothing on this planet? Okay, there is stuff on this planet. Okay.
Well, you build and then fight with it, but yeah.
It's the same thing. I'm for whatever reason, I'm just not a big builder. I mean, I understand some of you guys really like that type of shit, but it's just not my thing.
Do you imagine Pyro building a mole ship?
A mole ship. Yeah, I can see stuff in my head, but making the stuff that I see in my head actually a reality is the struggle. And, I mean, it just isn't fun for me because I feel like I can't do what I need to do to make this stuff work. So, you know, I mean, if it's something that I can actually, you know, pilot or somebody else can build it, then I'm okay with it. But if I have to actually physically build it myself. Okay, I hate this aspect. Look at the ground. There were a bunch of shadows moving around. Like there was shit up in the sky. Yeah, right there. There was a shadow. There's another shadow. Oh, that's because there is something up in the sky. Never mind. I was about to be like, there ain't shit up in the sky. All right, here we go. Sorry, little bird dude. Not my choice. I would have happily scanned you from up in the sky, but apparently... Where is it?
You have to die.
Yeah, apparently I have to kill it. Shit. I think it landed like right over here, but I can't find it now. Oh, god dang it. Dude, you want it? You want to go? We can fucking go, bro. Is that it? No. I could have sworn... Is that it? There it is, yeah. Oh! It looks like a little cute bird, dude! With, like, butterfly wing. Oh my god, I just murdered something. Oh my god. Look at this beautiful little critter, man. I just murdered this thing. Now I feel terrible. Oh... Well, Zalimthor, that's a little different. I don't enjoy building when I have to build it for functional or cosmetic reasons. I enjoy building when it's just a base. So if I don't have to build it to make it function or look good, then I'm okay with building. But like with games where you have to build a ship, the ship has to function, and I don't do very well with those. Because usually it's lopsided or just hideous and et cetera, et cetera. So... that's the difference. Okay, I've already scanned those. We got a bunch of critters off to the right, which we'll get to here in a second. Pop this. There we go. What are you? Oh, you are kind of creepy looking. And you look like some kind of weird camel thing. That's some weird looking shit. Not gonna lie. That's a turtle? That's like a badger turtle.
The thing has a weird hump on its back.
Yeah, I'm trying to get this other thing, but it's hiding in the grass. There we go. I think I got it now. What the hell? That thing is ugly. That thing is really ugly. It's got fins on. I don't even want to know. Did I get you guys already? What?
I'm waiting for it to catch up so I can see it. Oh.
Yeah, they're kind of ugly. No, like, I'm okay with building, like, I want to be able to build a base somewhere and things like that, and I'm okay with snapping on, like, pre-constructed parts and things like that. It's just, I don't like building a ship I have to fight from. It just never works out good. Ever. All right, is there no save spot here? I guess not. All right, you are 4 minutes out. You are... Okay, these things make... Oh, my God, look at that thing. Dude, that thing looks like... It's got, like, a Great Dane's body. Like, that sloped stomach thing that they have. But at the same time, it's like some kind of creepy-ass animal. What the shit? Holy fuck. All right, I hope you're not mean, right? Nope, you're not mean. Okay, good, good, good. There was something else over here. There it is. Trying to find them. Oh, what the hell? What in the fuck is that? Okay. So I found my first completely weird critter. Is that a hyena standing on its back legs? Okay, what in the absolute fuck is that thing?
It's a penis monster.
Yeah, we've... Okay, and this thing looks like a saber-toothed tiger. Oh, my God. What in the shit? Oh my God. What is he masturbating? He's masturbating. Oh, we didn't need to see that. There's the little baby tiger kitty thing. These are so... And you know what's really fucked up? These are the same species, too. Okay, there's something else down there. Is that the frickin'... Okay, got those. I think that's a wrecked ship. I just found a wrecked ship.
Remotely related.
Yeah, they're the same monster. Here we go. Hang on. All right, I'm gonna fire. Hang on, buddy. One sec. I'm gonna make friends, and I'm gonna make them have little babies. Are you guys ready for penis babies?
Oh,
God. What's up, dude? No, it's okay. It's okay. Yeah. It's a little hyena fucking thing. And this is some weird, creepy shit. Okay. So now they both... Wait, did you not eat? Here. Oh, what the fuck? What in the absolute fuck? Oh, my God, dude. Oh my God.
Their movements.
I know. Yeah, it's a little fucked up. All right, so I just found a pod racer over here. For those of you guys who are into Star Wars. Yeah, this is totally a pod racer right here. Totally. All right. I already know that, so that's useless. What is this right here? Debris, Vakreen distress beacon. I love how I didn't get to detect this thing. The cockpit is adorned with trophies of dead creatures perched on every available surface. At the controls sit a tendrilled hunter, its body and face lacerated. The dank smell of blood assails my nostrils as I fight back the nausea. The black box reveals the pilot was attacked by something whilst in flight, but it's unclear what. I could strengthen the warning beacon in the cockpit, but it would leave me vulnerable to attack. I've never messed with one of these before. I have no idea. So, if I sent out the signal, whatever killed it might attack me. Or I could search for signs of life.
Signs of life?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, signs of life probably the best. Let's do that. I discovered ship technology blueprint. Because that caused the carnage is thankful long gone. All right. Warp reactor Sigma. Good. All right, let's see. How bad are you fucked up? So that's a 21 slot. Compare it to mine, which is a 20 slot. That's a 1 slot upgrade. This ship has... It's basically identical, except it's completely fucked up. Can I dismantle this stuff? I can. So if I want to transfer all of this stuff over, I can... There we are. And then I can dismantle everything on my ship. Well, almost everything.
Freeze it up, too.
Okay, so... Shit. Okay, that stuff just simply cannot be disassembled, which is fine. All right, so I can move you. I wish I could break this down. Okay, I don't need the iron. Honestly, don't need the platinum. The heredium, though, would be really nice to have. Technology is critically damaged. I am going to need this Carmite. So as I understand it, if you want to be able to build something, but it shouldn't be super important to the overall goal of the game. No, Zalmthor. Like, okay. I'm perfectly fine building machines, factories, things like that. I'm perfectly fine snapping pre-constructed base components onto something. If it doesn't have to fight or anything and I can just leave it on the surface of the planet and call it my base, I'm okay with that. If I have to design something that has to do something, like a spaceship, a go-kart, a death robot, that type of shit, I have no interest in whatsoever. So hopefully that clears it up a bit. All right, we'll accept. Okay, so... let's look at repairing all this stuff. We'll start repairing that. Okay, we need carite sheets. Okay, that's fine. Hyperdrive is going to be busted for a bit, so we need a lot of carite sheets. Okay. And let me close this real quick so I can see. Let's do carbon. Surely I got more carbon here somewhere. Yep, there we go. And some iron. Alright, let's fix this. Okay, so we need carbide sheets or whatever they're called. So I need 4 of them. Okay. There we go. Now we're getting some free slots. Oh my god. There we go. Okay. Now I need some zinc, which is going to probably be problematic. That I can fix. Warp reactor is going to take a little bit. What do we got here? Cooling system. I need nickel, which I thought I had. Okay, 3 more carite sheets. 6 more carite sheets. Okay. Need to find some iron. There's some. There we go. 6 more carite sheets. I'm gonna have to make them 3 at a time. Really wish there was a way to do these, like, in bulk, sort of. Okay, we need zinc. You boys don't want any of this, trust me. Trust me. You don't want none of this. Okay, good. You can do that and have it be AI controlled, so you can also just leave it. What? What do you mean, JJ?
I think he means the depths game.
Ah.
The ship.
Oh, I mean, it was an interesting looking game, but again, it looked like one of those games that you need people to play with for it to really be fun and, you know, like build your own ships and such. And that was like the whole part of it. So, I don't know. Let's go to this drop pod over here. And we can just keep building stuff as we go. What are these things here? All iron? Did we discover all the species here? No, we're missing 2. So, 2 more critters out here somewhere. Hey, Pryor, what games are you playing today? That kind of depends on some stuff, but for right now, we're going to be playing No Man's Sky. I had planned on playing quite a bit of, Dead by Daylight, but the game doesn't want to cooperate right now, so... I figure we'll give it another shot here in a little while. There we go. I wouldn't mind playing some Paragon. Although you gotta not suck, okay? Can't suck today. I'm surprised they haven't added ranked yet. Cause I thought they did, we just couldn't see it because we were too low level, but it seems like it just flat out isn't in the game yet.
Keep moving. I mean, they're working on a lot of stuff all the time. I think they'll get it soon enough.
I don't know. For a MOBA, for me, like, ranked gameplay's like right up there with, like, you know, heroes and such. That's a pretty big aspect if you want to be competitive.
Right now, I think they're filling their hero library is one of the biggest things they're working on, because they're putting out a hero every 3 weeks right now. Because they only have, like, 20. So I think it'll be soon enough, because they are doing other stuff besides building heroes, but...
Let me come over here and get this Vakreen word. Any Overwatch later? Overwatch is currently in between seasons, so that means no more ranked play at all until September 8th or September 9th, I forget which. We will probably do some PTRing. I just don't know if Timmy's got it done, and Timmy and I will be queuing together and exclusively. So, at least for our placement matches. So we want to, the reasoning behind it is they are adding a new, quote unquote feature this time. What is shaking? It was weird. Like the world was shaking. They're adding a new feature in this season of Overwatch, which again starts September 8th and is on PTR for test right now, that you cannot queue with people that are too low, in rank from you. So it's going to be very similar to, what do you call it? CSGO or any other ranked games, in the aspect that you are not going to be able to queue if they're too low. So if they're too low, it's not going to work. What's in the new update? Couldn't find any patch notes. Mouse. Well, it's if you're on the experimental build, it's just the experimental build that they pushed to live. If you're not on the experimental build, like if you're a PS4 player or something like that, basically, I don't know if it's on PS4 yet. I'm on PC. I heard it was, but again, not sure. Basically, they've increased performance, fixed a few crashes, supposedly. Increased performance on PC for a variety of different lower-end systems. Increased some multi-core support of lower-tier and normal-tier systems. The patch notes are on Reddit. So, I just don't remember. You should be able to find him if you look on Reddit. I think it was on the front page. How much is Paragon? Paragon's free to play, bro. Free to play. So, nothing really exciting. SAFCX just basically releasing stuff that's going to fix stability and such along those lines. So, if you were having problems playing the game prior, you may want to give it another shot and see how it works for you. It may be an improvement. It may not. For me, I did see an FPS improvement, but it still has the occasional hitch. So your mileage may vary. All right, let's look at the old ship. What do we got beat up on it now? So we got the zinc. We need heredium. We need a lot of heredium. Okay, that one I can fix. Carbide and heredium. Iridium and copper. Nickel. And then three. Okay, so we need to find a heredium log, which we should be able to find here pretty easy. No worries, SAFC. Yeah, I hit that. Okay. All right, so we have shelter. None of these I really care about. There's a transmission tower again. Don't care. Shelter, and then that should be the dropship. Yeah. We're going to head over here to this drop pod real quick, because that's more or less what I care about. And while we're moving, we're going to see if we can't find a heredium log, as I like to call them. A lot of critters over here we need to learn. Okay, land here. Oh my god. Those are some seriously large, freaky looking critters. I'm doing well, ProPixel. You're having a hard time obtaining the hyperdrive tech. Are you on PS4 or PC? Whoa. Did I miss the zinc plant? Am I just blind? You're on PC? Interesting. There is a glitch with hyperdrive tech. You were supposed to learn it in basically the tutorial. More or less, it's given to you as you go through. So it sounds like you may have the glitch on the hyperdrive. Rumor has it. Oh, wow. That is a creepy looking plant or mob there. Dude, it has no face. Oh, wow. Okay. Interesting. But yeah, there is supposedly a bug with the hyperdrive stuff. Like, if you do certain things with, like, the pre-order ship in the wrong times, then it can break your ability to get the hyperdrive tech. I didn't have that problem, so I didn't do a whole lot of research on it, but I did see a lot of people talking about it on the Reddit. So, I do know if you do the... What is that? Oh, that's Iridium. We need Iridium. If you do the tutorial, basically you just keep following the quest, you're supposed to get it. That's how I got mine. I don't remember all the details on how I got it. It is part of my series on YouTube. So, you know, if you really want to know, you can go that way. Or you can just hop on Reddit and see it. You can probably Google, you know, No Man's Sky Hard or Warp Drive, and they'll more or less give you a bunch of guides on how to get it. But like I said, it was supposed to be part of the quest line. Got your eye on any upcoming games? Honestly, this was the one I was looking forward to. Well, maybe not looking forward to, but very cautiously optimistic. It kind of did exactly what I thought it was going to do. I pretty much expected it to be extremely hyped up. I expected a lot of people to be very hyped about it, and then it kind of, not necessarily flop, but just not deliver on the promises that people thought it was going to. So it kind of, in some sense, did exactly what I thought, but at the same time, there was enough here for me to personally find it enjoyable. So my only concern, I guess, really at this point is I kind of expect the game to get old fairly quickly. That's my only real concern. So, you know, your mileage may vary. Power watch the video you posted about Overwatch on Twitter, and that was really sad. I thought he killed the bird. Nah, it wasn't sad. I thought it was... I don't know. I thought it was kind of cool. I liked it. I thought I got some serious Terminator Rise of the Machines vibes from it, which I thought was kind of cool. I guess I can understand how people might have found it sad, but I just thought that fight was amazing, and I would have loved to have seen a little bit more of that. And by a little bit more of it, like, I want a 12-part Hollywood movie series that this is like 20 hours long, so I can just watch it all. Yes, ProPixel, that's about it. That's about what I remember. They teach you antimatter, and then from there you go and learn other things. It's like antimatter and then like solidifying solution or something, and then after that it's you learn the hyperdrive. But if you have the pre-order ship, you can actually get the hyperdrive before you learn it. But I would recommend completing the quest, because I think if you leave that area, then I think that's the bug, is if you leave the area before you do that, then you might not be able to get it on the second run through, and then you're stuck because not all ships come with a hyperdrive. But I'm not sure. I don't remember the details of the bug because I just read it on Reddit in passing, and I didn't experience it, so I didn't have to take a closer look. Ah, yes, warp cells. I forgot about that. Now let's get the suit, and then we'll do the upgrade. Mining resources that are on the ground don't actually give you the items, by the way. Really, Krillic? What? I've been mining them and gotten items. What do you... I'm confused, Krillic. Do you just mean like the part that's under the ground? Krillic, I've gotten a mixture. This one is a fairly pretty one. A lot of them, definitely not so pretty. Oh, okay. So if it's underground, the part that's underground, you don't get credit for it. Gotcha. Makes sense, I guess. Okay. Our ship is over here, and I saw, I think, a Heredium log over here. So we're going to go mine that real quick. Whoa, hello. Oh, that's not good. Yeah, we're running close to being... Let's move that. Well, fuck. All right, let's go. So, Pyra, are you going to find Atlas? From what I understand, and this is going to basically have some loose spoilers on it, so if you're wanting to not have a small possible aspect of No Man's Sky ruined for you, then you may not want to listen. So you've been warned. From my loose understanding of reading Reddit, basically the point of No Man's Sky is to quote unquote get to the center of, and I don't want to say galaxy because I don't think it's galaxy, the universe or the galactic center, which is kind of weird. Anyways, once you get to said center, and you can get there by apparently a couple different ways. One of them is by following the Atlas path, so to speak. Free roam, and there may be another, but those are the two that I'm aware of. Once you get to the center, you discover something, or don't. I won't cover that because I honestly don't know. I haven't looked into that. But then, supposedly, you go to a new galaxy, and everything just starts over. So... That's the gist of it. So, I'm not sure if I'm going to follow the Atlas Pass side of things. And the reason I say that is, okay, is that the closest one? I thought there was one a little bit closer. Yeah, there's that one. I guess that's it. Okay. I guess that works. Will this end up on the Daily Planet? It'll be a No Man's Sky stream, but not necessarily a quote-unquote Daily Planet. Mainly because I'm answering questions and talking about a lot of other shit and, you know, not necessarily focusing on the planet side of things. So, yes and no, if that makes sense. All right. What can we repair? I'm missing a dynamic resonator. What about you? I need carbide sheets, and then I need nickel. So I need to free up one inventory spot, or we're going to be in some trouble. What is this? Deflector enhancement? Starship energy shield is strengthened. I would actually break down some of these. Yeah, it's going to give me 50 nickel and 50 platinum. The problem is I can't store the platinum, I don't think. I mean, I can over here, but I can't over there. So, I'm going to probably have to get rid of some things, which is unfortunate. Oh, the fucking inventory woes in this game are just real. Actually, there's Heredium, which is what I'm going to get here. So, never mind. I'm okay. So, am I going to follow the Atlas Pass? I don't know. Part of the problem was... there was a guy who discovered my stuff right off the bat. So I don't know if I'm going to even be able to because the path, from what I understand, is linear. So the path basically for the Atlas path, it basically takes your current position, the center of the galaxy, and leads you through there. Unfortunately, from what I understand, it doesn't do so in a, what's the word? I don't want to say logical pattern. Okay, two Karite. It just does it from a standpoint, and then a dynamic resonator. Can I make a dynamic resonator? It does it based on your lowest warp drive. So, for instance, if you can only go 50 or 70 light years, then it does it based on 70 light years. Well, if you can go 1,600 light years, it still supposedly bases it on the 100 light years, or so I've heard. So if that's the case, it's not very good to follow that path because you're going to be sitting there for a long freaking time trying to get there. So, there you go. There you go. Okay, so my pulse engine drive I can fix, but my hyperdrive is going to require a dynamic resonator, which I sold a while back. So I'm not actually going to be able to get into hyperdrive. And the other thing I just realized is I actually charged my hyperdrive with antimatter before, which is really going to piss me off. So I'm going to need two new dynamic resonators to fix both of these. Now this I can fix by just getting some plutonium, which is kind of funny because I know I have plutonium. Yeah, I got plutonium right here, but I can't move it over. All right, so I guess let's fix... I need two Karite sheets. I only have one Karite sheet over here. There we go. That's going to free up everything. So there's Karite sheets. And I really wish these Karite sheets could be stacked. I think it's kind of silly that they can't, personally. Okay, fixed. And then thomium. There we go. All right, so that's nickel, which I don't really care about right now. I need three Karite sheets to fix this and a bunch more heredium. But I've only got two sheet slots here. I can't store the zinc or the iridium. Have you been looting off North Korea off camera? No. No. But isn't it different to the direct way to the core? Troubled one, I honestly don't know, man. I've specifically not looked at all the spoilers because, you know, I don't want to ruin the game for myself. So, I do read Reddit fairly religiously, but not from the standpoint that I'm looking for every single tip and trick and thing along those lines. Because, you know, if you... Basically, from what I understand, if you want to get the game over with quickly, you just need to build the four warp reactors, surround the top tier with the lower tiers, and then just plot straight to the core. And you can get there fast as hell. And well, maybe not fast as hell, but fast-like. The problem with that is, you know, you miss out on hundreds of hours of gameplay. And then you kind of turn it into a job and, you know, you're not enjoying all of the aspects of the game. So, you know, that's the way to do it if you're wanting to quote-unquote min-max it. I've never been a min-maxer. I just don't enjoy that playstyle. So, your mileage may vary. If that's something that you are cool with, then by all means. Has anyone made mods for this game yet? I did see a website that was talking about mods. It was a website I'd never heard of, affiliated with no company I'd ever heard of, so I kind of avoided it because, like I said, I don't trust just random shit on the internet, at least until it's been verified by other people. So, but yes, there are mods out, or there are people claiming there are mods out. Things that basically just quality of life improvements, like right now, there is a... if you're familiar with Instagram, Instagram has quote-unquote filters. And those filters change the view of what you're looking at. And some people think they make them pretty. Some people think they distort it and make it look like shit. It kind of depends on your definition. Well, No Man's Sky, if you look at it right now, there's a little hazing in the top left, top right. And there's a bunch of other filters that are on. Well, you can actually get a mod that will strip all that away. So it just looks like it would quote-unquote normally look. So it's interesting. So I don't know, like I said, I don't know about the legitimacy of that website or whatnot. We'll see. Did you see the AMD Zen compared to the Ryzen 3 years? Is NVIDIA the Ryzen by hair on a blender high quality? No, I have zero interest in AMD Blackhawk. I used AMD for a long time. Intel won the war. I'm not saying that AMD's bad, but if you can afford Intel, I don't see any reason why you wouldn't. They're the industry standard. They're the top tier. So, for me personally, yeah, I'd probably stick with Intel, but that's just me. All right, where's the ship? Ship is a minute and 40 seconds over this way. We're still missing like one or two critters, which I really would like to find before we blast off. But I am having a little trouble finding these last few critters. Now, AMD processors, from what I understand, are fairly good at a lot of different things. And like just raw gaming, they're probably fine. But for what I do, i7 in my experience has always been superior. Hyper-threading and, you know, multitasking, video editing, you know, that type of stuff. So I've always focused on that. So that's kind of what I hang out with. Pyro, you have one copper. Why? Do I only have one copper? I don't even see copper in here. Oh, it's green, right? I have eight copper, actually, Maya. Eight full coppers. Why do I only have eight copper? Most likely I built something that used the majority of the rest of it. Copper is found fairly easily in space, so I most likely was mining it in space. I had a bug yesterday in one of my recordings that was kind of annoying, and it required me to do a rollback. So that's probably part of that, because I was mining copper. Basically, what happened is I got engaged by bad guys, and they were pulling me out of warp. So I did an Elite Dangerous move. If you've ever played Elite Dangerous, you may be familiar of it. If you're going to get interdicted, you just pop out, so at least you get out on your terms, so to speak. Well, the problem with it was when I did that, apparently it broke the encounter. So of the five ships that were attacking me, two were close, three were stuck out in space at a predetermined distance, meaning I could not close range with them because they technically didn't exist, but they were there to interdict me, which was a real problem because I couldn't catch them. So because I couldn't catch them, there was no way for me to more or less advance. So I would have had to fly an hour to the closest space station or reload my save. And so I ended up reloading my save, which kind of pissed me off because it lost me about 30 minutes, which is another one of my big complaints about this game, is the aspect that you literally cannot save anywhere you want anytime. You have to either jump out of your spaceship, not jump in, jump out, or hit a save point, which I think is silly. Do you think there will be DLC for base building? They've said there will. I have no reason to believe they wouldn't. So for now, yeah, I choose to believe them. You know, no idea if they're, you know, telling the truth or not, but I choose to believe them for the most part. There's been a lot of controversy over the game, though, I will say that, and a lot of it's kind of disappointing. So, the game is not everything that they promised it would be. There's still a lot to have fun with here, and if they manage to get everything in that they promised, it's going to be an amazing game. But the question is, how long is it going to take to get the game that they promised us? So, you know, if that takes a couple weeks or a month, then that's one thing. If we wait a next year or so for the rest of them, then it's not going to work. So, Top Hat Gamer, when are you going to be playing Dead by Daylight? Dead by Daylight, we tried to start the stream off with it, Top Hat. It didn't work. The new DLC has apparently broke some shit. So, or not new DLC, whatever you want to call it, the new content patch. So, I won't be playing it most likely today, because it doesn't work. We try to get it working. Acrylic, I don't know, buddy. I'm not so worried about having everything claimed, because in my experience, there's still a lot of room in the universe. So I don't, as big as the universe is, I don't think many people are going to be claiming enough of a percentage of the galaxy to interfere. I have bumped into one person. I didn't see them, but I saw the stuff that they had claimed. So, you know, yes, if that happens in bulk scale, then that could be a real problem. I don't know if that's going to actually be a legitimate issue for the vast majority of people. So, for instance, okay, I love how I'm literally 2 feet away from that damn thing and it's not counting. Oh, well. This is going to be like Minecraft, where at the beginning of MC, there was only dirt, cobble, and void, and look at it where it is today. Blackhoff, if it actually works out that way, then yes, that will be amazing. The question is it going to actually work out that way? And we don't know yet. So, okay, so this is an 18-slot multi-tool. I have a 19-slot multi-tool. So this is the first downgrade I've ever seen with multi-tools. So yeah, I won't be picking that up. Thank you, buddy. Okay. Hello? Pyro, will you be checking out the new Hearthstone expansion? I'll be honest, my interest in Hearthstone has kind of waned in the recent months, mainly just because the cost of keeping up with it. I don't have the money anymore to buy packs. So, and then the grinding, with the new changes from normal to standard, I didn't have enough cards to make top tier decks, and the grinding of 30 hours to get them just doesn't do it for me anymore. So that, and it's even worse because, I had a lot of cards back in the day, but as we move forward, my cards become less and less valuable. So the further behind, each expansion, I don't hit the curve on, so to speak. And what I mean by that is the ability to make a top tier deck, then I fall further behind. Does that make sense? So it just seems to be kind of a losing scenario at this point. So, it's a good game. Don't get me wrong. I like it. And I do play it from time to time. But it's not going to be one of those things that I'm gonna keep going with long term. All right, so the warrior looks at me with fire in his eyes. The species is clearly aggressive, and I doubt I'm welcome. Yet the life form bows in greeting. Tradition and honor perhaps dictate it. I don't feel in imminent danger, and am about to turn and leave when the creature points to my multi-tool. It barks with concern and makes a motion to suggest that I should hand it over. He says he's going to replace something. So I'm hoping he's not going to replace my whole tool, but I will go ahead and give him the credit that he's probably going to hook me up. The warrior respects my decision. Okay. What? Did he just fucking take my multi-tool? Okay, I don't understand. I have no idea. It didn't even tell me what happened. It was like, thanks, GG, and leave it at that. Oh, did I click refuse? All right, let's do that again. Let's try it again. That's what happens when I'm reading chat more than what I'm doing. Okay, he's calling me an interloper. Indicate the answers are not currently insulted. Well, that's good. So I'm just an ally. I don't need any of that stuff, so I guess we'll just cancel out. Okay, never mind. He tried to betray the Vakreen by giving up, and you gained influence. Gotcha. So I kind of lucked out there accidentally on my stupid misclick. I'll take it as a win. Yeah, this is one of the other things about No Man's Sky that annoys the fuck out of me. I landed my ship right there. This is the landing pad. I feel I was close enough. The problem was, because of the height, it did look like I was close enough. So I wasn't quite close enough to actually land on here. So it would be nice if it would actually, let you land in those places. Nah, Maximalist, I'm good. It my accidental misclick actually turned out to be pretty good. So we're gonna enjoy the misclick, even though it was a misclick. We're gonna take it and run with it, so to speak. All right, let's check out over here real quick. Whoa, a little bit of lag there. One of the few times that Pyro stupidity works out. I wouldn't say necessarily stupidity. I would just say distraction. But your mileage may vary. If you angle it right, it shows you three arrows pointing to the landing pad, and there is a monitor that lets you call your plane to it. Oh, I'm aware I can call my ship to it if I don't mind spending, some resources making the chip. I don't want to do that. I think if you're within a certain period of, or a certain distance, then it should automatically land. That's just my opinion. So, all right, Brigadier. What's up, dog? Pyro, what did you do? I misclicked. I meant to say yes and screwed up and clicked no. Interloper! The warrior silent for a second before he looks at me conspiratorially. He looks behind to check for his colleagues before powering down security systems. The warrior pulls open trade vault at its feet, which seems to be piled high with multi-tool upgrades. It indicates the contents of my inventory as a trade. So I know we're not going to give him 100 carbon because that's like garbage. If I give him 1,000 units, then most likely I will get an upgrade from this guy of some sorts. However, if I report him, which I'm an ally, so I should be able to do. If I report him, then I will gain faction with them and may or may not be reported. Or may or not gain faction and an item. So now if I threaten to report his ass, he may just give it to me. So I mean, I guess. God, he is ugly as shit, isn't he? Yeah, I think threaten to report is probably my best option here. Probably. And Krillic seems to agree with me. Yeah, not so Slim Shady. I figured that one out. What's up, Dizzy? How you doing, buddy? Yeah, I guess we're threatening to report his ass. Well, this drives me nuts. Because I wouldn't mind an upgrade. Like, if I could get a tier 4 scanner upgrade, that would be huge. That would be absolutely huge. But at the same time, if I beef up... why do the Vikin not like multi-tools? Hellspawn, I think they do like multi-tools. The issue is, this guy is a smuggler, basically. He's hooking me up with, like, an under-the-table upgrade. So he turned off the security cameras and he's doing some dirty shit. So that's why it's bad. And the other guy I think was going to kill himself. So that's why. You probably will misclick again. You know what, Aaron Tanasia? I don't think I like you anymore. You kind of hurt me in the feels. You found like no good new multi-tools? Yeah. I've struggled with that too. Yeah, I'm gonna pay him. The warrior sighs and slams the train due to vault shoot. The units are presumably traceable by the authorities. Wow. So I should have just threatened to report. Well, I guess he did actually want the carbon? What the fuck? That was weird. Exactly. So he did want the carbon? So, like, was carbon the only right answer there? Because that seems a little fucked up. That seems a lot fucked up to me. Jesus. All right, well, lesson learned, I guess. No, we're gonna go with our choices, so... Carbon is everywhere and not traceable. Well, I mean, I guess it is, but like I said, the issue with it would be... I know, exactly, Slim Shady. I mean, it can't be carbon, because if I had given him carbon, carbon, number one, is everywhere. Number two, I already knew the word for isotope. So unless he just didn't use isotope. So like literally the only successful option there was to report the guy, which is fucking weird. I don't even understand. A wild potato has just subscribed for 13 months in a row. Thank you so much, Potato. Appreciate it, buddy. High five. Subs, light him up. Let him know we love him. All right, let's hit this transmission tower. See what we got. Hopefully something amazing. Oh. Okay. So 1, 2, 6. So we doubled to 2. We tripled to 6. We quad to 24. And I'm pretty sure 24 times 5 is 120. Let me verify that real quick. So 24 times 5 is 120. So 120 times 6 is going to be 720. So the answer is 720. How's the game? Dialank, interesting. It's kind of a complicated answer. I enjoy it, but a lot of other people might not. So I'm curious to see how it grows over the next couple months, so to speak. Oh, gotcha, Krillic. I thought they were varied. I didn't realize they were the same over and over and over again. All right, let's go take a look at this other crash ship. It may be better than ours. And our ship's honestly a piece of shit anyway, so we can go and get the new one. People say Sean lied to us. I don't think necessarily Sean lied. I think more along the lines of Sean has really big dreams and he has really big plans for the game. And unfortunately, he's not currently been able to get all of those said plans into the game. So I think as long as support is big enough to maintain, that we're going to see some really nice future content from No Man's Sky. And that's what I'm hoping for. But I guess we'll find out here in the future. Game does seem really fun, but may have been too ambitious. Yeah, possibly. Not sure I like sparks coming out this thing. Not going to lie. All right, how much open inventory space do I have? Not many slots. Check out the damage machinery. New technology discovered. I like that. Anything that's beam oriented is a win for me. The opulent furnished interior suggests the dead pilot once belonged to one of the race's more affluent families. The cause of its mid-flight demise is unclear, but the ship is likely to be carrying a decent cargo. The body lies draped over a large box covered in dangerous-looking alien markings. A strange black mist surrounds the scene. This is kind of disturbing, actually. This is kind of disturbing. If I open the box, it could be bad. Like, it could have, like, the alien version of, like, Vespine gas in it. And then if we search for loot, we might actually find something. I agree, Dizzy. It's almost like it's the same option. It's like search for loot or open the loot that you've already found that could be death. So, kind of a toss-up here. Ah, fuck it. Live. Let's do it. We're opening the box. As I open the box, the dark energy channels through me like poison. The tech I find within the container has something. Alright, so I got hurt for doing that, but my shield's held, so we're fine. We're fine. You take damage? Okay, I'm all right with that. I'm all right. I'm perfectly happy taking that damage. At the viewpoint of a software developer, I can tell you something that simple might have been pushed back for more important stuff. Assume they were ambitious but didn't have enough time to put everything in you decent degree. I agree, Maximalist. I mean, that could happen. The concerns that I have with that, and here's the problems that I have with that side of things. And yes, I agree that a lot of things probably did get cut, and as somebody who struggles with that myself, who thinks big and has a lot of really good ideas and wants to implement them all, I mean, like at one point in time, I had 4 YouTube channels. So, you know, I know what it's like to have a lot of really awesome ideas and want to, you know, implement them all. But at some point, you can't do everything you want to do. You know what I mean? So here's my issue. Twofold. Actually, threefold. Number one. They showed off versions of the game that had a lot of things implemented that we do not have currently. And they talked about things that were in the game that we do not have currently as little as like 2 months ago. So that's my issue, is they promised. They showed us things that we don't got. Number two, they did not give media outlets, let me rephrase, specifically, they didn't let us YouTubers have access, period. And they told us specifically they would. Sean tweeted out that they were setting up a keymailer for us, and that they would hook us up with copies once the new version came out. None of us got it. Now, I'm a smaller YouTuber, so it's possible that I might not, because I'm small. But Total Biscuit didn't get one either, and that dude's fucking huge. So one could argue that they just didn't give him an early copy because they knew he might be hostile. But at the same time, I don't know of a single YouTuber who got an early copy other than on console and didn't break ship date. So the previous statement, plus the fact that they didn't give media access, is bad. Because now it's like, okay, you had to cut some shit, but then you didn't let us see, you know, then you didn't give media access. Okay, that's two bad things. And then number three, just the fact that they were so hedgy about the stuff that they would let us see. You know, they didn't go into detail on a lot of stuff. They kept things overly vague, et cetera. I mean, it just wasn't good. And so then finally, you know, the fact that the trailers on Steam that they are using to sell this game have a lot of stuff that isn't in it. That's bad. So all that being said, I enjoy the game. And I'm not hating on the game. I'm just saying that that's like four or five things that are really bad. So, you know, we don't know what happened. I mean, like, Sony is their publisher, so Sony may have forced them to release the game early. They, you know, may have had some technical constraints. There's some people that think that the algorithm that they used to make the game got into a big fight with the guy who created the algorithm, and that may have had some of it. They had to remove the algorithm. Who knows? So I guess the question comes down to, are they going to be able to implement the game that they showed us and the game they told us about? Are they going to be able to implement it in a timely fashion? As long as that stuff happens and those are yeses, then we're okay. But, you know, if the backlash is so big that they have to do layoffs, and which I don't think is going to be the case considering the game sold like crazy. So I don't know, man. I don't know. It all depends. It all depends. Okay, so I'm going to leave for now. And the reason I'm leaving for now, because I believe I can pick it back up here in a second. We're going to take the stuff off of our starship. So, well, some of the stuff off of our starship. We're going to take an emerald. Take that. Actually, I'm going to drop the copper because the copper is too small. There's no reason for me to hang on to it. It's 8 copper. So we're just going to destroy it. Everything else is fine for the most part. Okay, chrysonite we have 500 of, thomium we have 500 of. I don't think I need that much thomium, but if we do, we're fine. All right, let's move over. Is tau better than sigma? QRST. I believe so. I'm aware, Maximus. The problem is I'm going to break all this shit down that's broken. So I just want to make sure that I get my parts is all. Whoops. I just threw all my heredium away. Oopsies. Yeah. There's a chrysonite. Platinum, I'm not going to be able to move over, I don't think. I wish I could repair this stuff. Like right now, but it won't let me repair it. I wouldn't mind keeping this density fabric, but that's fine. We have a lot more copper here now. How much? Nickel? 50? I'm keeping the copper. I think the copper is a good choice. Yeah, Maximus. I'll keep. Oh, that's a good point. We don't need iron. We can make iron. This is 62 platinum, 29 chrysonite. I can find both of those on the planet if I need it. So, let's see. Take the chrysonite. No, I mean, I guess that's true, but there's so little of it. Eh, all right, fine. I'll accept your wisdom, good sir. All right. So, our ship. You know, I just realized our ship's actually here. I could just run back and forth and pick this stuff up. I just realized. Yeah. I can actually come over here and interact with it since it's right here. And I can move this stuff. So, I wish I could just take this, but I have to compare. So I can still move stuff back and forth while doing the repairs, which is kind of cool. That's a pretty big house. That's a pretty big house. Okay. I don't know why I got in the ship. Did not have to. All right, we want to repair this, so we need 4 Karai cheats. And then we're going to need to fix this, which is Heredium and Karai cheats. So I need 6 Karai cheats. 6 Karai cheats. How much inventory space do I have? I have no inventory spaces. All right, let's try and store what we can store real quick. Is that it? So that's giving me 3 spots. So let's make the Karai cheats. That should give me enough to get at least one of the pieces repaired. Wait, there's one more. There's one more. All right. So fix this. And then this one needs 2. There we go. Whoops. Okay. And then there we go. We're gonna need a lot more plutonium here and pretty quickly, actually. Why do you have more slots in your ship? I've spent a lot of time upgrading my personal inventory. Personal inventory is pretty easy to increase. Ship inventory can be a little bit more time consuming. Let's see. Here we go. I was hoping to find some plutonium out here. Speaking of, I haven't done any scans for a while. Do we have any critters? Because we only need 2 more critters here to knock this planet out. How much money will we get for knocking this whole planet out? We have 1 more critter. 175,000. You know, that's probably worth it. It's a free 175K. We'll come over here real quick and see if we can find it while we hunt for some plutonium. And if we find it, then great. If we don't, then we'll dust off. It could be these up here. There's like 3 or 4 critters up here. Let's see. I thought I saw something lower. Yeah, there's friendlies over there. Whatever it is going to be up here. Okay. All of those are previously discovered. There's some plutonium down there. Yeah, pretty much maximum. Now, keep in mind, to upgrade your inventory, you have to do that over and over again. So it's basically the same thing. You're still spending that kind of money. It's just to get the ship, you have to buy it all at once. To get the inventory, you know, it's 200K here, 400K here, 200K there, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So it's a much slower, quote unquote, power creep. Whereas with the big stuff, it's very, very, very fast. So if that makes sense. What's up, Kissamaha? How are you doing, buddy? All right, we're going to jump down there, hit that, and then we'll swing over there and see what that is. There we go. What you up to, buddy? Oh, hang on. Sorry, thought we had a message from Kitty Cat. Thought she was up. Apparently not. Nothing there. All right, let's get these real quick and we'll check up here. Come on. Whoa, what the fuck was that? Got vacation from Army, got a month left in, so happy. All right, well, that's cool, man. That's cool. There's that critter right there and a couple up here, so I guess we'll check out over here and see what we got. Really would like to get the last little bit here. Yeah, those are ones we've already discovered. What the fuck is that? Okay, nothing there. Holy shit, that thing's big. And apparently our last critter. I think. Yep. That is our last critter right there. Look at the size of that thing, dude. Creepy. All right. Let's name some critters. Who wants to be the last big, ugly, fat thing? I'll give you a choice. You can either name it after yourself, and I can just put your name into it, or I can allow you guys to name it. It's up to you guys. Doesn't matter to me either way. Dark Lord Frost wants to be the weird zit thing. All right, Dark Lord, you want me to just call it after you, since you were the first person, or do you want to name it? Big Breasted Llama. Oh shit, Hellspawn. Oh shit, dude. I almost wanna. I may actually have to call it that, Dark Lord. I may. I really like Hellspawn's name. That was. Although I will say it doesn't really look like a llama to me. It looks more like a camel. So Big Breasted Camel, I think we're gonna go with. All right, Big Breasted Camel. Big Breasted Camel. All right, there we go. So there's the camel. I am not gonna name plants because that would take forever, but we will do critters. All right, here we go. This is the smaller breasted camel. The comparison between these two is kind of funny. They're basically the same critter. So humor of a 13-year-old. Oh, okay, Swan. All right. Your turn, Swan. You get to name this one. You get to name this one. Since, you know, you have a better option. Go ahead. Go ahead. Blow us away, Swan, with your amazing naming for this critter. What's up, HC Ronald? How you doing, buddy? Yeah, I'm with you on that one, Maximalus. We don't grow up. We really don't. We men are simple creatures. Leave its name as is. That is a cop-out, woman. That is a cop-out. Nope, you got to name it something. All right, you know what? You know what? Because you copped out, I get to name it. There we go. We're calling it the Hunchback Swansea. See, this is what Swan looks like when she first wakes up in the morning. When she first wakes up in the morning. All right. We got another one, the Nafisar Manati, which basically looks just like the other three, but slightly different. Slightly different. What should we call this one, guys? Anybody got a good name for it? That's another one of kind of like my disappointments about the game is sometimes you get on a planet where like all of the creatures look exactly alike, which, in all fairness, isn't necessarily a bad thing because, you know, think about all the creatures on Earth that look very similar. You know, you got all these different species of dogs. You've backwards dick wiggler. Really? Really, Hellspawn? Really? Oh my god. The backwards dick wiggler. Lip Dungle McHumpback. My god, dude. You guys are awful. You guys are awful. Holy shit. You know, like, I'm embarrassed to name it that because somebody might actually see that one of these days.
I'm thinking Teenage Mutant Ninja Great Dane, because it reminds me of a Great Dane. Like, its body style is totally Great Dane, and then you got like the weird, creepy, like zit on its back that's just disgusting. It's got like hooves in the front, doggy things in the back. Backwards Dick Wiggler can't unseen. Oh my god. Yeah. Boil Dane. I like it, Krillic. Thank you. You've helped me out. All right. Boil Dane. I like that one. Thank you, Krillic. Thank you. All right. So what about the Alaskan Husky lizard back? I mean, I think we should call this one. We should totally call this one not a husky. I mean, this one really needs to be not a husky. I think that's like the best name. Erection. You know what, Krillic? I was all excited because you were bringing like maturity to the channel, and then you just threw it out. Maximalist is like, they see me walking. Pimp lizard, werewolf lizard. Oh my god. Upright Hyena of Doom. Yeah. How about pimp walking hyena lizard? I think that one's good. I like that one. All right. Pimp walking hyena lizard. There we go. I think we're all right with that one right there. Pimp walking hyena lizard. Maybe I should put a space back there. Can I do that? Oh, wow. I have to actually press the backspace. That's crazy. Pimp walking hyena lizard. All right. And then we got one more. Well, we got a. I don't know what the fuck this thing is. This is like the pimp walking hyena lizard, but with like some kind of shark head on it. I don't understand. Like, what the hell do we call this thing? I mean, for reals. Did I just name the bird? Oops. That's what I get for spam holding E. Later, dude. Later, Krillic. Have fun, man. The Strut Walker Pyro. I call it the Strut Walker. Oh my god. Time 6628 is just resubbed for a 17th month in a row. Thank you so much, Time. Appreciate it, buddy. High five. Subs, light him up, let him know we love him. Pyramid Head. They see me walking, but I don't. Call him Dickhead. Oh my god. Oh my god. All right. We're gonna call him Pyramid. Well, Pyramid Head doesn't seem to work. All right, Troubled. If you want it named after you, sure thing, man. Troubled One. I don't like any of the other names, so we're just gonna go with that. All right. We have like four critters here that are like the exact same critter. So we need one good name for these. Dude, these two are ugly as hell, man. These are faces only mother can love. You're calling it Egyptian? What? No, man. No, that doesn't work. What's up, Bannerino? How you doing? So we need a name for these three variations. Aqua lizard. See, this one looks like an aqua lizard, so that one's okay. But these two... they just, like, that face is derpy as hell. I mean, like, oh my god. Oh my god. I'm Batman. All right. We'll do that one. We'll do that. Batman. All right. Now we need two more names, or one name for these two. Oh, we're going to call this one Robin. We're calling this one Robin. Since we have Batman, you have to have Robin. So should we call this one Joker? Because I don't know. The quick hump. Yeah, I think we're calling this one the Joker. Or the Penguin. We could call it the Joker or the Penguin. Which you guys think's better? Because we got to stick with our theme now. It doesn't really look like the deformed penguin. The mutant penguin. Joker. So we have one for Penguin, one for Joker. We need a tiebreaker here, folks. We got 1-1. Help me out here. 2 for Joker. A killer croc. Ah, I forgot about that one. Name the last one Harley Quinn. That's hateful. That's hateful. Killer Croc. I kind of like Killer Croc troubled one. I'm not going to lie. Penguin cause bird, but it's not a bird. Was the Croc's name actually Killer Croc? Because I don't know anything about DC Comics. I was more of a Marvel guy growing up. So Killer Croc. Okay. I'm going to assume that's the name of Croc. Okay. Killer Croc. Okay. Now we have two last critters, I think, to name. We got this one right here and this one right here. And they basically look the same. Yeah. This one's pretty hideous. This one is very hideous. I don't know what we're going to call this one. I understand a penguin is a bird. I was saying that the creature is not a bird. So I don't know how you can call it a penguin. Hoppy and Floppy. I'm all right with that. I don't know if Floppy is actually Armadillo Kitty. Bizarre. That's Armadillo Kitty. That's actually kind of cute. Except it has a lot of teeth. But I mean, I guess kitties have teeth too. So I kind of like Armadillo Kitty, unless anybody's got a better name. Hippity and Hoppity. That one's not bad either. So Hoppy Floppy, Hippity and Hoppity, and then we have Armadillo Kitty. I kind of like Armadillo Kitty. Neither one can fly, Pyro. Well, I agree, Squid, but like, this is obviously not a bird, bro. This is not a bird. This hasn't been a bird ever. Ever. Armadillo honey badger. Oh, wow. I actually like that one. All right, well, here's what we're going to do. We're going to do Dillo honey badger. And then we're going to do honey badger Dillo. That'll work. All right, let's get our 175K real quick. Boom. Get all these in as well. All right. Where's our ship? Our ship's back this way. I'm a bird. A penguin is a bird. Okay. I see what you're saying. You're so angry, Swan. You need to chill out, girl. Chill out. Relax a little bit. All right. Get this stuff and go. I am rather happy we were able to find that last little bit. I was a little worried, I'm not gonna lie. There we go. Ooh. Smile, Swan, you message your mother with that keyboard? She probably does, actually, yeah. She probably does. That was a lot of chrysanite there. What's that? Heridium? Okay. Whoop. Okay, so what do we need here to get off the ground? We can get off the ground right now. So that's good. What can I... I need to get a dynamic resonator for sure to repair the hyperdrive. And then we kind of need to just unload some of this shit. Because we got like a lot of stuff on us. Let's, we have to name the planet, y'all. We haven't named the planet yet. So this is the planet that I did, I think, yesterday. Yeah, so I've already done this planet. We'll go ahead and... This was the yesterday's episode, and this one is right here. So what are we calling this planet, guys? What are we calling this one? We gotta have an awesome name for this planet, with all the wonderful creatures we've got on it: the big-breasted camel, the hunchback Swansea, the boil Dane, the pimp walking hyena lizard, the troubled one, the killer croc, the robin, the Batman, the Dillo honey badger, and the honey badger Dillo, Bulbasaurin. Call it literal shit. The Arkham Discovery Channel, Wartville. I actually kind of like Wartville because like half of the shit on this planet or on this place has boils on it. So I'm okay with Wartville unless somebody's got a better one. I like Wartville. Anybody else? Going once, going twice, going three times. Oh. Amazit Hynation, Hyenaton, Pustule. Now you're just getting a little fancy there, troubled one. All right, we're just going to go with Wartville. All right, so A, B, C. So this is going to be TDK Pyrostasis Charlie. TDK Pyrostasis Charlie. There we go. All right. Let's get off this shithole. What do you guys say? Oh, wow. If I take any damage, this is going to be bad. Whoop. All right. There it is. There we go. A pyro does not like fancy speak. I don't necessarily have any problems with fancy speak. Just... Okay, I can't recharge the deflector shield because they're both fucking broken, so... You know what, Swan? I'm gonna have my girlfriend beat you up. Okay? She's gonna beat you up. I really wish I could turn off that annoying noise. Whoa, 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 whoa! Okay, we're all right. That almost sucked. Definitely don't want to slam into the space station with no shields. That seems to be problematic. Oh, wow. I'm glad we managed to make it inside before the bad guys engaged. Just give her tainted bread. Gotcha. Oh, I know, right, Novafire? You could take Timid. Nah, you think you could take Timid, Sinister. She just sounds sweet. She's fucking gangster. She'll mess you up. Let's be honest. She probably would. That's a good point. I didn't even think about that. Thanks for that, Zalthor. I appreciate that, buddy. The syrup ain't helping against a freaking swan. Those are vicious. Why do you think Timmy has to be syrup? Just because she's Canadian doesn't mean she's actually syrup. Hell's wrong with you people? The hell's wrong with you? Nah, my girl will pass. She'd tear all you people up. All right, let's see. Sell items from your inventories. Where are we at? I really would like to sell the Atlas Stone, but not here. Not at that price, anyways. Dude, the prices at this place are fucking garbage, man. Although they do seem to really like zinc and really like heredium. Although, 54 a piece really isn't that much. I mean, if that's above the galactic average, that's just not worth it. Not worth it at all. So what I'm probably going to do with the ship here is I'm probably going to break down all the broken shit, just carve it up, and then I'll rebuild the stuff that I want. That seems to probably be my best option. So, Alm Keaton, if you've seen the notes for the experimental patch, then that's basically it. It's more or less just performance issues for AMD, some lower end systems, some higher end systems, mouse smoothing. I'm trying to remember what else, bug squashing and things like that. There's not a lot of like content, so to speak, in it. Just mainly some performance tweaks. And that's about it. Name the ice planet Canada. That's good stuff. I like that. I like that. Oh, this ship looks cool. If it's what I think it is. Yeah, those kind of look cool. I like how they're all lined up. Yeah, that's kind of interesting. Oh, that one looks like a damn albatross. Yeah, that's not happening. They're all albatrosses. What the hell? Yeah, these two ships are... This is the first time I've ever seen two identical ships before. Like, down to the markings. That's so weird. I've never seen two identical ships before. I've seen similarities. Like, you know, that one is kind of similar to this one. But I've never seen two exact identical ones. Austin Dale, we're going to be making some people very happy with PC. AIM Keaton, they're making people happy because they're fixing the issues. So, yeah, that's why people would be very happy, is there's a lot of people that were not able to play the game. So that was the happiness there. Zalandor, are you still in the chat?